Hi, it's Francesco, Tsiot, developer advocate at Aiven. In this video, we will check how you can create your own fake dataset using Python and Faker, a Python library. We will do that assisted by a Jupyter notebook, which allow us to browse the code and execute each code section at a time. So let's start. This is my Python notebook, and you will find references to it later on. So the first thing that we need to do is to actually install Faker. And we can easily do that within the Python notebook by prefixing the code block with bash and then writing the usual command to install the Python libraries, which is pip install Faker. If we run this piece of code, we will see now that in my case, the library is already installed, so your output probably will look a little bit different. Nevertheless, we will have Faker installed in our computer, so now we can make use of it. What we can do is we can import, and then we can create an instance of Faker. Now that we have an instance of Faker, we can just start creating fake data. So if, for example, we need a fake name, we call the name function. If we need a fake address, we call the address function. If we need a file name that sounds like an audio file name with an extension MP3, well, there is exactly the file name function, which accepts a few parameters that we can customize. So let's try to run this code. What we see here is that we got a Peter Rodriguez, clearly fake name, a nice fake address, and a b.mp4 file name, which possibly could sound like something related to audio. Now, let's dig a little bit more into Faker, trying, for example, to localize the Faker instance in order to produce what I would say, like you see here. What I want to do is produce Italian sounding fake data. So we just need to pass the IT locale when we create the instance. And now every time we call the name, the phone number and the address, they should sound like Italian stuff. Let's try this out. Well, if we see the data, Dottor Nico Tozzi is a pretty Italian sounding name. The plus 39 and then the rest of the phone number sounds an Italian phone number. Then we have Borgo Carmelo 0, Piano 0, Tina Terme, 34726 Savona, VA, which sounds like an Italian address, probably will not be a correct address, but sounds Italian enough. So it's good. However, with Faker, you can not only create file names, names, addresses, and phone numbers. Faker has a huge list of predefined providers and also community providers that allow you to create a huge variety of fake datasets. For example, if we need some banking data, we can easily create a bank country, an IBAN, and a SWIFT address just with the available functions. And what we will see is Great Britain, a nice IBAN, and also the SWIFT code of a bank. All sounds fake, but real. Of course, since we are now in Python, we can also nest several different data parts, fake data fields, into a more complex structure. So for example, we have a message composed by the name, the phone number, and the address. All really easy. Griselda Falcone, phone number, address. This is now becoming something complex. If now we want to go back to the fact that Faker provides a lot of different providers, I've been telling you that, but I didn't show you which providers are available. Let's browse them. If you go to faker.readthedocs.io, you can find the Faker documentation, which is really good. Allows you to install, to use, to manipulate the Faker instance. So I strongly suggest to read it. Within the documentation, you can see the standard providers, and the list is huge. So you find addresses, automotive, banking, barcodes, colors, companies, going until my favorite, the Python one, which allows you to create fake Python code. The list is huge, but of course, we cannot expect Faker to cover all the possible use cases. For example, again, I'm Italian, so I want to produce fake pizza names. Faker doesn't do that. I was really disappointed when I found that out. How can I enhance Faker? Well, it turns out that I can easily increase, I can easily add new data types to Faker. So let's check this out. If I want to create my pizza provider, all I need to do is to import the random from Faker and also the base provider from Faker. Now that I have both, I can define a class pizza provider, which extends the base provider. Within the class pizza provider, I have a method called pizza name and an array within it that contains the list of pizzas which are provided by my pizzeria. The last thing that I need to do within the method is return a random choice between the valid pizza names. So easy, I created an extension of Faker, which now allows me to return and to create fake pizzas. If I run this, I have my extension being added to Faker. I want to make use of it. Well, I just need to add the pizza provider to the Faker instance and then create 5 pizzas. So let's run this code, and we can see that we have a Mario Monti as first pizza, 3 margaritas, and a salami. It's working. I've shown you a piece of code and I run it, but I didn't tell you one thing. What does this Faker seed 1234 does? Well, when we are creating fake data, we may want to fix the origin of the randomizer, the seed of the randomizer. Why? Well, because if, for example, we want to use fake dataset in order to test a platform, and we want to have the same input across several tests of the platform, well, this is the way seeding the randomizer will let us obtain exactly the same result next time that I will execute the code. So now, just remember Mario Monti, Margherita, 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 Salami. If we rerun the same block again, we should have the same dataset. Let's run it again. As expected, we have exactly the same dataset. If on the other side, we always want to have unique and different values, we just have to remove the seed and we will be able to run, and we have Margherita, pepperoni, pepperoni, Margherita, Margherita. If we run again, we have Diavola, Marinara, Margherita, Margherita, Margherita. Beautiful, it's working. What if I want always to have different values? Well, of course, I have an array of 6 values for the pizza names, but if I just prefix the pizza name with unique, Faker will try to always generate different pizza names until it runs out of options. So let's try this out. Well, by prefixing with unique, the first is Diavola, the second pepperoni, salami, Mario Monti, Marinara. Since I have enough options, it will never repeat one of the options, all working as expected. So in the last few minutes, I've shown you how you can create your own fake data. If you want to know more, what can you do? Well, first of all, reach out to Faker documentation. As I said earlier on, it's beautiful. The second thing is what you're using your fake data for. Well, within Aiven, we offer several open source data platforms, which include Postgres, MySQL, and also Apache Kafka. What I did, I created an open source GitHub repository that you can use, you can clone, you can start using in order to recreate fake pizza orders that are produced to a Kafka topic. All you need to do is to clone the repository, set up the connection to your Kafka, and off you go. If you want to know more and learn how you can produce your own fake producer for Kafka, there is also a blog post available at aiven.io blog, create your own data stream for Kafka with Python and Faker, that you can read in order to check out how you can create your own dataset. That could be pizzas or could be something else. If, on the other side, you're interested in understanding how you can use Python notebooks and Kafka together, well, there is also another GitHub repository which is called Kafka Python Notebooks, that allow you to basically understand the basic of Kafka and Python together within a notebook. You will find all the links in the description below. For now, it was everything for today. Hope it was useful for you. Ciao from Francesco.